is His will that every need be supplied. You are important to me. I need you to survive.
Words from my mouth. grace. Father, we give you glory tonight. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for that song reminding us all that we are on the same team and that we need one another to survive, to do this Christian walk. We need one another to remain encouraged, to hold each other up when things are looking tough and obscure. We need one another to say, hey, fix your focus. Fix your glory gaze back on the Heavenly Father. He can do anything but fail. God, we thank you and we praise you for another opportunity to come into this house. We have entered into this place and into your courts with praise, God, with thanksgiving. God, we have a song on our lips. We have joy in our hearts. Lord, we're not worried about being happy or whatever else the world or culture is telling us to be. We are excited because we have the joy of the Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for being our strength, for being the truth in this sin-sick world. And God, I pray as the service goes forward tonight that your name would just be glorified. Strengthen us all, Lord God. Help us to hear from you tonight. Help us to have a heart to receive what thus saith the Lord. Strengthen our man of God. Lord, give him what he needs to be able to deliver the word with precision, authority, power, and all that you have bestowed upon him tonight. Thank you for your Holy Spirit dwelling on the inside of him and the Holy Spirit dwelling on the inside of us so that we can all partake at the master's table tonight. God, I thank you and I praise you in advance for what you're going to do, God. And I pray for all of those who are unable to join us in the house tonight, Lord. We pray that there will be no technical issues, Lord, that technology will be doing what it's supposed to do so that no one will miss a word from you tonight, God. Meet them right where they are in your name, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Well, welcome to OIC. Amen. We have made it back for another midweek empowerment service. This week seems to be going by quickly but slowly at the same time. You know what I mean? Sometimes, I don't know. And I truly feel like time is speeding up. When you look at people like little baby Cairo and you remember how he was tiny 2 minutes ago, time is speeding by and you need to be ready. Ready. Amen? So we'll just go over a few announcements before we proceed in the service. If you have not yet done so, please follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel, both entitled Overcomers in Christ Ministries. We encourage you to be active, to participate, and go on the Facebook page where you'll see all announcements. Anything that you want to know about Overcomers in Christ is on our Facebook page, but stand by because our website is loading. Amen? The website is loading. I'm almost finished, so pray my strength in the Lord. That's not my, you know, that wasn't my, not my ministry, but it wasn't my specialty in the Air Force. You know, I was not IT, but, you know, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, and we have adequate resources at our fingertips to help us to accomplish what we have been asked to do. So, amen. Next is our prayer call, which is every Tuesday and Thursday morning at 7:30. So, tomorrow morning at 7:30, set your alarm for about 7:25. You know, get up, go brush your teeth, splash your water on your face, and dial the number 605-562-8401. Access code is 168-2332. You just call in, you get a word of encouragement, and then we just pray. Just put your phone on mute, go on about your day, you know, if you've already started getting ready for work, or, you know, you're like Sister Samuel who gets up at 3 and keeps on rolling till 10 p.m., put the phone on mute and pray with us while you're doing your natural job or whatever it is that you're doing. Amen? Next is we have intercessory prayer every Saturday morning right here in the house. Amen? At 10 a.m., another opportunity to pray with like-minded believers. And if you are unable to make it in the house, then you can use that same conference call line that I mentioned before. Next is it's Wednesday, Bible study night. And so we're obviously here in person, back in the house. You know, the Bible says to not forsake the gathering of the people. And so we're not saying the pandemic is over. However, you know, come back. it's safe to come back. You know, we're still taking precautions and whatnot, so feel free to join us in person. We would love to have you. Amen. And we also stream that live on the Overcomers in Christ Ministries page. So be active, participate, please, and thank you. Next is we encourage you to invite at least two people every week to church. We have our little invite cards that I usually have, but they're over right by the door. So, you know, you saying a hello or goodbye, just bring it up casually or, you know, just randomly. How many times have you had somebody just say something random to you, right? So why can't the believer do the same thing? Do you have a church? Do you have any plans for Wednesday night or Sunday morning? Saturday morning, come on to the house. I know a great church who would love to have you, who would love on you, or, you know, give you elbow bumps if you're not trying to, you know, get a full embrace. Come on out. Be the church. Go out and bring people in. Amen. Now it is Galatians 6 and 2 Ministries. We are partnering with them this month. And for those of you who are not in the house, I wish you could see the back corner over there. Somebody, a little birdie told me somebody went shopping on today. So we've already delivered a ton of groceries and, you know, all the things over to them last week, I believe it was. And so now this week we have another huge donation to give to them. So, you know, we are definitely blessed to be a blessing. And it just makes us feel good to be able to sow into someone else's life. Amen. Think back to the times where you didn't have it and you prayed hard that somebody would just come up to you and say, can I help you? Do you need anything? So this is your opportunity to give. For more information on that, look on our Facebook page. Amen. It's offering time. Hallelujah. Again, we're blessed to be a blessing. The ways to give are you text the number 803-373-1878. You text the word give. Or if you've already established an account, I just type in the dollar amount that I want to give. So whether it's $300, $3,000, you know, I believe big. So, you know, I'm not going to say $3. No, I believe big. Don't you spend more than that at the Starbucks? So how much more is your Heavenly Father worth? You know, sow into the kingdom. Amen. You can also use Zelle with the email address oicmpastor@gmail.com, or you can mail it to P.O. Box 1291, Elgin, South Carolina, 29045. If you're here in the house, you can also put it in the offering box in the back. Amen? All right, so if you all rest on your feet with me, get your tithes or offering in your right hand. Let's go ahead and pray. God, we thank you and we praise you just for being God. Thank you for all the many gifts that you have bestowed upon us, Lord. And we know that we are sowing into your kingdom, God. Every time we have an opportunity to give, God, we jump at the chance. We are enthusiastic. We are cheerful, hilarious givers because of how generous you are with us, God. We can't help but to be generous back with you, Lord God. And I pray that you would just bless this offering that we collect tonight, God. And meet every need, God, the things that we have spoken out of our mouths verbally or may have mentioned to somebody, and those things that only you know, Jesus. I pray that you would meet every need in the name of Jesus. God, we give you thanks and praise in advance. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Hallelujah.
One through 16. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, who is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thy trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shall I behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder. The young lion and the dragon shall thou trample under feet. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. You may all have your seats. As is customary for our midweek empowerment, we have what we like to call a midweek review. Yes, Pastor does not call it a quiz anymore, so we're going to review. Are you ready? All right. So, and this is going to be tough. I'm just going to tell you right now. What were Sunday's main scriptures? What was Sunday's main scriptures? Yes, Hebrews 10, 24 through 25. And there was another one that Pastor John spoke on. It starts with a P. Proverbs. Yes, I win. Proverbs 27 and 17. Yes. All right, number two. Define the word king. Define the word king. Yes, a group of people working together for a common purpose. Purpose. Even Pastor John said, no, purpose. Team is a group of people working together for a common purpose. The next question, what was the title of Sunday's message? Remember we had our jerseys on, hint, hint. What was the title of Sunday's sermon? On the same team. Good job. We're all at the head of the class. Next one. This is a fill in the blank. God gave mankind blank to decide which team he wants to spend eternity with. I say again. God gave mankind blank to decide which team he wants to spend eternity with. Yes, free will. So you know how when somebody comes up and asks, well, why this and why do I have to do that? Because God gave us free will. And like Pastor Shaban always tells us, make good choices. But in church, we like to spin that to say, make God choices. Amen? Be ye set apart. Be ye holy, for I am holy. Come on. Amen. Number five. On Sunday, Pastor John told us that there are only two teams to choose from. Who are the teams led by? There are only two teams to choose from, according to Pastor John on Sunday. Who are the teams led by? Jesus or Satan? Nope, he said Jesus. But either God or Satan. Yes, I'll accept either of those. Joy said S-O-G and E-O-G. Ooh, I tricked you. I tricked you. See? You see how it was tricky, tricky? I said, who are the teams led by? I didn't say, what would the teams call? All right, so that was my next question. Joy, you're at the head of the class. What are the team names, according to Pastor John? But we can add something to it. What does S-O-G and E-O-G stand for, according to Pastor John, these aren't official things, you know. According to Pastor John, what is S-O-G and E-O-D? What does it stand for? Yes, Saints of God and Enemies of God. How many already playing in their t-shirt? S-O-G. Not E-O-D. S-O-G is going to be in the house, amen? Pastor John says a lot of things, y'all, so we be ready. Pastor John said, I want one. Amen. Saints of God. All right, next. Everything we do ought to have an, if it's three things that Pastor John mentioned, everything we do ought to have an, and a, yes, aim, focus, and a mission. Amen. Me and my sister are winning. All right. There is a scripture Pastor John mentioned on Sunday. I'll read it to you. You tell me where it is in the Bible. I told y'all it was hard, didn't it? Okay. And be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, hath forgiven you. And be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, hath forgiven you. Starts with the E. Ephesians 4 and 32. I told y'all I was going to win, and I have. All right, your last question for the bonus. How did you become a member of OIC? There were three actions that Pastor John mentioned when he talked about how you became a member of OIC or a church in general. Three things that you need to do to become a member. You don't want to just be sitting down, you know. You got to do what? All right. Well, as I mentioned, me and Pastor John won. Connect, commit, and serve. Amen. In order. Yes, you get connected, then you join the commitment, and then you serve. You put your hand to the plow. Huh? Come on, somebody. We don't just come in a church and sit down and look cute. We come in, we connect. We commit ourselves. We say, yes, I want to become a part of this. I want to know how your lives are so different from mine. And then we say, how can I help? How can I use the gifts that God has given me to help with this amazing church? Amen? So that has been your midweek empowerment review. Thank you for your time. And now put your hands together for our very own pastor, Pastor John Salisbury.
Amen. With the ups and downs, we're still blessed. Amen. Is there any blessed people in the house? Amen. Hallelujah. We thank God for each of you who are tuned in and watching us live stream. Can y'all put y'all hands together for those watching us by live stream? Amen. We have some faithful folks that are watching and praying for us, supporting us, and amen, speaking God's word over overcomers in Christ. Amen. We love you. We're praying for you. Amen. And we're thanking God for you. Amen. Truly, God met us here Sunday. Amen. With a powerful word on the same team. How many believe that as a born-again believer, we are on the same team? I made a mention, you know, we had Jersey Sunday, and in the traditional Pentecostal church, there's no such thing, amen, coming to church without your shirt and tie and suit and all the things. But we did have Jersey Sunday representing one of your teams. And I remember saying I was had a couple concerns with those who had some jerseys on, talking about their team. But, amen. God bless anyway. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We're going to piggyback, if I could use that word, from Sunday's message. We're going to talk to you this evening on the same team, part two. You will, well, Pastor John, why do you always repeat what on Wednesday night what you taught on Sunday? Because Pastor wants you to get it. Amen. Amen. So that you get a second chance at hearing it again. Amen. And so we want you to turn in your Bibles. Pastor Pat, we love you. We're praying for you. Amen. We really miss you. Amen. Open your Bibles, if we would, to Hebrews, the 10th chapter, and we're going to read our text scripture from verse 24 and 25. I'm going to read it to you from the Living Bible translation. Amen. Say amen when you're there. All right. It reads as thus. In response to all he has done for us, let us outdo each other in being helpful and kind to each other and in doing good. Verse 25, let us not neglect our church meetings as some people do. Amen. But encourage and warn each other, especially now that the day of his coming back is drawing near. Amen. Father, I thank you for your word. Father, I thank you that you will speak tonight. Give us an ear to hear what the Spirit is saying. God, loose every shackle. God, loose every heart. God, remove the boundaries. Oh, God, help us to receive your word, God, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You may have your seats in the presence of our life-changing King. I want to read that same passage of Scripture, Hebrews, the 10th chapter, verse 24 and 25. From the King James Version. Amen. We hear Minister Sayla always trying to say, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together. It says, let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to good works, not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together, as the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. Amen. When we're talking about on the same team, amen, every member of the body of Christ is valuable. Y'all agree with that? Not only are you valuable, but you're important in God's kingdom. Amen. Many people sometimes feel insignificant. They thinking they may need a title. They have to be on the platform. But when you have submitted your life to Christ, you are valuable and you are important to the body of Christ, and you're important and valuable in God's kingdom. Amen. Not only are you valuable and important, but you have been commissioned by God to do your assigned part, edifying, uplifting, inspiring your sister and brothers in Christ in doing good works. Amen. Hallelujah. God did not save us, just as Sister Shayla said, just to sit on our seat and let the world and everything pass us by. But he has given us a mission, amen, to encourage and to love on one another. Amen. Hallelujah. And one thing about team, being on a team, we must learn, even in the body of Christ, the value of each other, the value of being a team. Amen. And we shared with you on Sunday that we need each other. I don't care how saved you are, how many tongues you got, how many languages you can speak. You need your sisters and brothers in Christ along this Christian journey. Amen. And with the help of the Holy Ghost tonight, I pray that this review, amen, this midweek empowerment, that you would get even more sensitized to why God placed you where you serve at. While you are a member of your local church family, and I'm talking to overcomers in Christ, you have got to understand why God picked you and chose you to become a member of Overcomers in Christ Ministries. Amen. You are part of a team. Somebody shout team. Amen. And so when we look at it, well, Pastor John, God didn't say we on SOGs and all that. Amen. But he has said in his word to work together always, to be together, lift up one another, encourage one, exhort one another. Amen. That sounds like teamwork to me. Amen. You're not going to encourage somebody you can't stand. Amen. All right. Maybe I have to preach to the walls tonight. Amen. And so when we look at different passages of scripture, iron sharpens iron. Y'all remember that, right? One man sharpens another. Ecclesiastes 4:9 says, two are better than one because they have a good return for their labor. That iron sharpens iron scripture is Proverbs 27:17. All right, another scripture in your hearing is Ephesians 4:32 that we probably didn't get right on the review. Be ye kind one to another. There it is. Amen. Tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, hath forgiven you. When you read this one in Ephesians 4:32, did y'all see anywhere where it says fall out with one another? Tell one another off. Give them a piece of your mind. That's not God-like. And he says, loving, tender-hearted. You got a special place in my heart, my brother, my sister. Forgiving one another. My God. Just as Christ has forgiven us. Amen. And so our first point that we shared with you on Sunday, it was, whose team are you on? Amen. That must be established before we can say whose team we are on the same team. Some people are declaring and confessing they are on our team, but they got the attributes of the other team. Lord, have mercy. Amen. My amen corner ain't here, but I got to keep going. Amen. And we said, you get to choose which team you want to spend eternity on. Amen. God has given every man free choice, free will to decide which team. Amen. What teams are there, Pastor John? Sister Shayla told us again. There's only two teams that really matter. It's not the Philadelphia Eagles or the Dallas Cowboys. Come on, somebody. Hey, that was a throw-off. Amen. Amen. It's God or Satan. Y'all understand that, right? Amen. And they are the leaders, the coaches of that prospective team. Amen. And so you must choose. We must choose daily. Amen. A lot of times we find ourselves, this journey gets tedious. It gets trying, and we find ourselves facing trials and tribulations. But we got to make it up in our mind. I'm choosing God's team. I'm not moving to the left nor to the right. I'm staying on God's team. Because sometimes on the team, it seems like you're all alone. It seems like, no, you don't matter. Nobody's paying attention. Nobody cares who, if you're suffering, if you're going through. But on God's team, somebody cares. Hallelujah. Yeah. Somebody cares. And I came to tell that one somebody, there's no team in the middle. Well, I just want a little bit of Satan's team and just a touch of God's team. No, no, the way of a transgressor is hard. Amen. If you're not for God, you are against God. Can somebody say amen? And we shared with you on Sunday, and I got a lot of ground to cover. Amen. Joshua 24 and 15, where Joshua told the children of Israel, choose you this day whom ye will serve. Y'all remember that. Whether the gods of your fathers that will serve that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land ye dwell. But here's the part that every believer got to know this. He says, but as for me and my house, somebody shout, my house, we will serve the Lord. I wonder, is there anybody under the sound of my voice is willing to make that declaration and decree before God? But as for me and my house, I said Sunday, I don't know where Sister Joshua was, but I don't know where the children of Joshua were, but he made a command decision. If you're connected to me, you got no choice in the matter. We going to serve the Lord. I just want at least one person able to say, I don't know what the rest of them going to do, but as for me and my house, oh, my God, my God. And just for the sake of analogy, we said God's team was the SOGs, just for the sake, talking about on the same team. The saints of God, y'all can type that in, the saints of God, amen, the SOGs, a group, a fellowship of believers, amen, a body of believers who believe that Jesus is the Son of God and the only way to heaven, because nowadays people are saying, go find your own truth. What's true to you, you live by that truth. But for the child of God, Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. And we submit to God's authority, his rule. The rule book, I didn't get to tell you this Sunday, the rule book is the Bible, the Word of God. Amen. And that's how we get our instructions of what to do on this team. Amen. Satan's team, we call them, just for the sake of analogy, the enemies of God, the EOGs. Amen. They consist of those who reject Jesus Christ. Unbelievers are those who reject the call to salvation to join God's team. See, what I like about God's team, it's open to everybody to receive. Amen. But there are going to be those that are saying, I don't want your God. I don't want anything to do with your God. And Hebrews 3 and 15, it says, today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation. Amen. We who have accepted Christ are on the same team. Amen. Well, let's break it down and even get closer to this, what I'm talking about. Your teammates being on the same team. Your teammates are your local church family. All right. Your teammates are your local church family. God has strategically placed you on his team where he has assigned you and a particular body of believers. Amen. I thank God for all those who he has anointed and appointed for overcomers in Christ for such a time as this. Come on, somebody. Amen. God has given you your assignment to commit, to connect, commit, and to serve. Don't forget that. And when we're looking at the signs of the time, it's time now that we need to be encouraging one another to keep on keeping on. Amen. You need somebody when life gets a little rough, when the edges get a little tough. Keep on going, sister. Keep on believing. Keep trusting God. Amen. Lifting one another up in our faith. Amen. Amen. See, we need one another as we navigate through life. We need the power of the Holy Ghost upon our life, in our life, leading us and guiding us. Because, listen, in the natural, we just don't want to reach out to one another. We concern about me, myself, and I. But with the power of the Holy Ghost, he says, esteem others more than yourself. Look at your sister and your brother and say, I love you. What can I do to help you? How can I be a blessing in your life? And that's, see, when we learn that concept, when we put it into practice, you often hear me say, time and time again, we must learn to be practicing believers. What are practicing believers? They are the ones that are practicing on carrying out what God has given unto us. If God says love one another, we want to practice loving one another. God says comfort one another, exhort one another. We want to practice. In other words, we want to put it in action. It's one thing that people tell, yeah, I'm a Christian, but they don't belong to a church. Amen. I'm a Christian, but I don't belong to any particular body of Christ. Well, who's teaching you? What is your foundation built on? Amen. And so you got to be able to discern the truth of God's word. Am I right about it? Here's a question I need you to focus on the rest of this week. Are you spiritually connected to your church family? It's one thing to, as I said Sunday, I believe, shake the preacher's hand and, give the right hand and follow all the natural rules, but that's not really committed and connected. Because people's name are on the roll in the pastor don't even know who they are. May I see them on that CME? What's that? Christmas, Mother's Day, and Easter. That's not truly connected, committed, and serving. Amen. But the question this week, I want you to really ponder, consider in your spiritual walk with Christ. Are you spiritually connected to your church family? Why is that important, Pastor John? Because the church is not the building. Amen. I heard somebody say it. Amen. You and I are the church. The people don't walk by the church building and see how the building's living. They are checking your life out as a testimony. You say you love God. You've been born again. Now, does your lifestyle testify about your God? When people says, well, what church you go to? I am the church. Amen. But I attend Overcomers in Christ Ministries. Amen. I am a faithful servant. Ah, Lord, help me. I am faithful to what I have joined and connected with. I am committed to serve. Amen. I am committed and connected, and I am serving. Amen. The Bible teaches us that God's church is God's people. Amen. In Acts 2, the second chapter of Acts, verses 43 through 46. Let's turn there. Amen. Since you brought your Bible tonight. Amen. Acts 2. We know in the second chapter of Acts when the Holy Ghost fell on them, the day of Pentecost. Amen. Let's look at what the early church, amen, began to do under the unction and function of the Holy Ghost. Are you in verse 43 Acts, the second chapter. It says, and fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles. Amen. Verse 44, and all that believed were together. Somebody shout together. All right, we going somewhere. And watch this. And had all things common. All right, first they were together. That means they spent some time together and had all things common. Watch this, verse 45. And sold their possessions, those possessions and goods, and parted them to all men as every man had need. In other words, they were asking, how can I be a blessing to you? I have this. I'm willing to let this go so that you can have. That's a body of believers, all right? All right, they were together, they had all things in common, they sold things and parted to every man that had need. Listen, you got to understand what's happening on God's team. Nowhere do it say every man went to his own house and stayed and locked himself up and worried about himself. No, they had all things common. All right, verse 46. And they continuing daily with one accord in the temple. They worship together. And breaking bread, watch this, from house to house. In other words, they didn't mind fellowshipping outside the church wall. Amen. They were like, let's get together. When can we get together again? It didn't say they were having chicken fries, fish fries. They just said they began the fellowship and break bread. Even if they were eating peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, come on. The fellowship is what counted. Do you know what happens when you begin to fellowship with your sister and brother? You begin to know them. There begins to be an intimacy that is developing. I got a love for my sister. I didn't know she liked some of the same things I like. I didn't know brother knew how to cut hair like me. But if you never fellowship, you would never know. Can I tell you this? We have more things in common than we have uncommon. Y'all not listening to me. Amen. I believe we should focus on what we do have in common and build on that foundation. Am I right about it? Whose team are you on? Amen. And we are moving. I can't get stuck here. Because listen. If we're not spiritually connected to our team, on the team, have y'all ever seen a team member? Everybody else is out there cheering. They watching the runners and the players and the ball getting hit, the ball getting kicked, and you got that one player sitting on the corner down there. Look like I really would want to be somewhere else. That is not demonstrating team spirit. Amen. And it's not encouraging. It's not uplifting. I can guarantee when they come to the sidelines, they're not looking to sit by him. Because you're not giving off nothing. You're not pushing us up. Come on. We may be losing. We may be in the fourth quarter. And if I get my energy, if I'm supposed to feed off what you're supposed to be giving, I don't want what you have. You got some folks in the church like that. They giving all, and we don't use this word in the church, bad vibes. We don't use that, but they have a bad spirit. And you're like, how can you be on God's team living with a bad spirit? Lord, this wasn't part of my notes. God help me, Holy Ghost. You hard to get along with. You causing problems in the church. Your spirit is contaminated with something from the other team. And God said, now is not the time to be contaminated in your spirit, in the fellowship with one another. Why is that? As you see the day approaching, we got to uphold one another. Hold on to your faith. Don't fall out and don't fall away. Are y'all listening? Amen. something about, I love about what God is saying in these passages of Scripture. We need one another's support. Somebody type that in. We need one another's support. Amen. Because listen, on this journey, we're going to need some support, help, sooner or later. A building that is going up, if it don't have the proper support of beams and foundation, guess what? It's not going to stand the test of time. Amen. Can I tell you this? In the church, you're going to need some support system when you're going through your trials and your tribulations of life. You need the physical support. You need emotional support. You need spiritual support. Is anybody listening tonight? You need somebody to speak in your life. You need somebody that will say, I can help you with that. You need somebody when you're having one of those off emotional days, says, sister, come on, brother. Come on, let's not think that way. Let's think and say what God is saying. I don't care how holy you are. There are times when we feel drained and frustrated and hard to get along. And you need somebody that is not going to get pat you on the back. Just keep building. That's good, honey. No, no. You need somebody that's going to speak faith. Come on. You can make it. You're going to get through this. This too shall pass. All right. Amen. You and I were not meant to go through life unsupported. Amen. Hallelujah. We need one another. My point number two, good Lord, I'm still behind the time. Consider one another to stir up love and good works. Consider one another to stir up love and good works. Amen. I said, Sunday, if you remember, I said, everything God does has a purpose, an aim, and a focus. Somebody need to write that down. Everything God does has an aim, a focus, a purpose, an aim, and a focus. Amen. He never created us to be alone. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Just concerned about me, myself, and I. You got some folks in the church, amen. All they want to do is come, they sit, they go through the church service, and they run out the door without shaking hands, without encouraging their sister and brother, without just speaking a word over somebody's life. And you wonder why you're feeling disconnected, because you're not properly connected. Amen. In order to feel apart, and many people have said this, we have witnessed this, I could never be a part of a large church. Well, you probably don't want to go to heaven then. Because if you think heaven's only going to be your four and that's no more, you're sadly mistaken. If you think your church is the only four people saved and on the way, heaven might not. You need to rethink. Well, let me explain. We went to a large church. It had more than 35 people. Went there a couple more years. It grew to 500. A couple more years, it was over 800, somewhere between 800 to 1,000 people. And we forgot all about that saying, nobody will get to know me. But this is what we did. After we connected, we committed, and then we began serving. I'm telling you something that works. When you begin to serve and you're committed to it, people will come to you. Hey, I saw you doing this. And how you doing? My name is. Before you know it, you got a spear of people that was like, hey, Brother Salisbury, hey, sister. And before we knew it, we felt like we knew everybody. But still, it had 1,000 people. Like, it got to the place like the pastor will never. We thought the pastor would never know. I'm just so insignificant. He's had people here 20, 30 years, and he'll never know. With the first time, watch this. I'm telling you the truth. The first time the pastor, we were in close proximity, he walked up and said, God bless you, Brother Salisbury. I almost passed out. This is a true statement. You ask Sister Salisbury, I couldn't believe, how did a pastor with 1,000 members know my name? I'm not going to give the secret. Amen. But he had a system set up where he had every new believer, every new member, he had their information and picture. He had their picture on the wall. He praying. He's memorizing. God's giving him insight. Name with face. Name with face. And so when you walked in, he remembered your face and your name. I'm so glad God knows me by name. Woo! My God. I don't feel like no stranger in the body of Christ. I can go to Timbuktu and fit right in with a body of believers because we got the same spirit of faith and the same coats, Jesus Christ. Woo! If we really understood the importance of our church family, amen, we wouldn't always be quick to dismiss one another. Amen. Because y'all know flesh gets in the way. And a lot of time we try to, it's a job. You got to work at loving folks. Some folks act like they unlovable. And when you go to hug some people, y'all just look that way. They act like they don't want to be hugged. They don't want encouragement. They look at you like, why are you saying God bless it? Because that's what God wants me to do. I want God to bless your socks off. I want God bless you going out and coming in. I want your storehouse full and overflowing. Because I love you. Love will make you do stuff like that. Amen? Tell your neighbor, I need you. And you need me. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. When we consider one another to love and good works, it's more than saying, God bless you. That's the easy part. Amen. And God bless you, and you send them all out the way. No. It's more than that. You got to commit. How can I really help you? Well, I need a tank of gas. Well, you know gas isn't for free. Many people see, this is so good. Many people are willing to help, but when it don't cost nothing. Y'all remember what we talked about, a sacrifice. It is not a sacrifice if it don't cost you anything. Amen. Just don't ask me to give out of my pocket. Don't ask me to give up my time. Well, that's what it's all about. That's what sacrifice is all about. Showing your sister and brother, I'm willing to spend time with you at any cost. If you need somebody to minister to you in the wee hours, call me, text me. I'm willing to wake up and pray for you because I know God is going to get the glory. Nobody wants to see a sister and a brother laying by the wayside. Amen. In this passage of Scripture, amen, it says, consider one another. Consider each other. Amen. And I begin to say, I've heard that word consider somewhere else. And I did my search in Hebrews 3:1. My time is running. It says, wherefore, holy brethren, partakers of the heavenly calling, consider the apostle and high priest of our profession, Jesus Christ. Amen. In other words, what this passage of Scripture is saying, consider Jesus. Amen. As you look to him, as you think on him, focus on him, study him, let your mind be occupied with him because it's all about him. Y'all ain't saying nothing. In other words, what you saying, Pastor John? Jesus is the object of our consider. All right? So if Jesus is the object of our consider, when I see my sister and my brother who has been blood washed, born again, I'm going to ask unto the Lord. I'm considering, what would Jesus do? Amen. I know that, man, when I'm at work and my mind thinks about brother so-and-so, brother so, and y'all at work and your mind goes, call them, text them, write them, pray for them. Hallelujah. It just don't happen by happenstance. Amen. I told you one testimony. We came home from a rough day at work and I saw Sister Salisbury praying, calling my name out. My God, I lost it right there. I'm thinking, oh, Lord, I'm getting ready to bring all of my problems to the house and tell her all my issues. But when prayer, when she began to call my name, that broke that spirit. And now I'm joining my sister. Yeah, she's my wife, but she's my sister in Christ. Isn't it good when somebody says, you came on my mind and I prayed for you? Well, what time is it? It was 13:15. That was the time I was in a bad situation. But God, y'all, I can't get no witness here. Woo! My God, consider one another. Why? Because when we consider one another, we'll treat each other just a little bit better. When we consider one another, amen. This is not the time to focus on your weakness. It's not the time to try to expose your faults. Amen. It's time to come together. How can I help you come up? Amen. And come out of these things. Well, we must love and support our teammates. I wonder, is there anybody here tonight? I'm almost done. We got to go. That can say, truly say, I love my church family. I love the team that God has put me on. And I am declared and decreeing, Lord, I'm here to connect, commit, and to serve with all of my strength, all of my might, with all that you have given unto me. When was the last time you were inspired to pray for your teammates? It's so important because we need to be praying one for another. And I'm just going to touch my last point, and I got it. I even close my Bible. I'll keep my word. Amen. We got to get together and encourage one another. Amen. Get together. And this is how we provoke our sisters and the brother to love and to good works. Here's the answer. Get together and encourage one another. Why is that? Because in verse 25 of the Passion Translation, it says, this is not the time to pull away and neglect meeting together, as some have formed the habit of doing. In fact, we should, watch this, come together even more frequently, eager to encourage and urge one another onward as we anticipate the day dawning. Amen. So how do I provoke love amongst my teammates and to do good works? First by coming to church. Do you know, and I got to close, my Lord, she put another 40 minutes. Do you know, you coming to church, you just don't know how it encourages somebody. They don't have to testify to you and about you every time they see you. But there's something happening in the spirit realm when a sister or brother see your spiritual, your persona, your smile, your fervor, your thank you, your praise, your worship, your dance. I can tell from a little boy when I was in church service just to see the saints dancing, testifying on miraculous things God does. I'm like, whoa, that was powerful. Even as a little boy, amen, and as you grow older, you learn to respect older saints of the wisdom and the experiences that they have gone through. It's like, man, where is Sister so-and-so? Where is Brother so-and-so? We're not asking to get in your business, but we are one. We get encouragement by seeing your faithfulness to God. But if you're not faithful, you're hurting somebody else. you don't know, and this is more powerful than you probably can imagine, you don't know who's watching your life. And if you are slipping and dipping and hiding and siding or whatever that word is, amen, are you being effective in your local church body? But just think about the ones who are faithful. I thank the Lord for another time, chance to be in God's house. I come to lift my hands. I come to do my dance. I come to testify. There should never be a time when we got to beg anybody to testify. How can you come to church with no testimony? I can't figure it out. Because as long as you got life, health, and strength, if there's nothing else you say, I thank God for life in another day to work out my salvation. That's enough to shout until eternity. I'm done. Stand to your feet. Our lesson tonight, the message is we got to provoke one another to love and to good works. Amen. It's going to cost some time. Amen. But God has graced us to do what he has called us to do. You have been given a local assignment in amongst a body of believers. Do it with all of your heart, all of your strength, and with all of your mind. And God will breathe favor on your life. Father, I thank you tonight, God, for your message to us that we're on the same team. Father, that you have commissioned us to encourage, to provoke one another unto love, oh God, to love one another with an unconditional love, just like you love us, oh God, and to do good works continually, oh God. God, put in us an eternal, how can I help you, my sister and my brother, oh God. Give us a willingness, a mindset, a kingdom mindset to be a blessing to the body of Christ, God. The place where you have assigned and chosen for such a time as this, oh God. Help us to be able to do our part in love. Not grudgingly, not unwilling, but God, with a cheerful heart. And Father, I pray for that man and woman that don't have a relationship with you. God, we know that you gave us the best gift ever, your son, Jesus Christ. And God, I thank you that he's still tugging at the heartstrings of every unbeliever, oh God. I'm not willing that no man should perish, but God, that they would join the heavenly choir, join the heavenly team, oh God, being transformed from darkness into light. We thank you for your faithfulness. And God, as we go the rest of the week, oh God, empower us even the more. God, help us, God, to be in prayer, showing love, demonstrating love to our sisters and brothers in Christ. And God, we'd be so careful to give your name all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Amen. You heard the announcements. Govern yourself accordingly. If you haven't had a chance to sow into Galatians 6:2, amen, the door and the window is still open, amen. I can just sense from her response that she is so grateful for us being next door neighbors, amen, and sowing into the ministry, amen, because it is being a blessing to somebody else. Let's do our benediction. Now may the grace of God, the love of God, and the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost rest, rule, and abide with you all, both now and forever. Amen. Amen. Have a blessed rest of the week. We love you.